God's Way of Teaching. Heaven Letter Number 4949. June 13, 2014. Beloved Beloveds, you are not the advisor to the crown. On one hand, you and I are one. You are a reflection of me, and, now, on the other hand, I tell you that you are not to make yourself a replica of God. In your costume as a human being, it is not your role to interpret me to others. I did not appoint you. You are not the sayer of me. The world is not your flock. In this sense, you are a member of the flock. Erase the idea that you are my appointed teacher, for then you presume to stand above another. I am the teacher. Unless someone comes into your presence for the purpose of hearing what you have to say, don't take on my robes. It is not for you to say that you know more than the person before you. It is not for you to embellish my words or for you to make the assumption that anyone needs your personal instruction. Be still. If you, as an individual, crave a pulpit, crave an audience, crave to be wise, recognize that you do not always speak for me. I speak for myself. If you want to teach, teach by example. Do not anoint yourself as an instructor, as though you have the final word. Know thyself. Teach thyself. Everyone learns me for himself. Quote me, fine. Support me, fine. Speak of me, fine. Bequeath me, fine. Yet do not you, as an individual, take it upon yourself to teach me to others as though you speak from on high. Be still. The great spiritual ones were humble, and so must you be, and not carry an authority of all-knowingness. What you see, not everyone has to see. What you like, not everyone has to like. Do not think you are meant to be a great explicator of me. You are the listener to the crown. As an individual, you do not take over interpreting me to the world. Frankly, the world needs me for themselves, and not your instruction. I am available. How do I teach? Through the human heart. The human heart isn't a know-it-all. Your human heart is not anyone's lord and master. Allow others' hearts to listen to me for themselves. My children are not your children who are to sit and listen to your every word as though you are God Almighty, and they, as supplicants, must learn from you. No one needs your teaching. You are not to appoint yourself teacher. Every thought from you is not the same as my thought. Every word from you is not the same as my word. In the world, you are on a different footing. Take me seriously, yet do not take yourself so seriously. I am speaking now of those who might take it on their own to be a stand-in for me as if the world is to hang on to their every word. I am not an excuse for anyone to aggrandize himself. You do not have underlings. You do not take prisoners thinking you do so on my authority. Does everyone in the marketplace have to know what you think? Is it your place to tell others what they are to think? For whose need is it that you comment? Be wary of inserting yourself as an editor for me. Do not put false gods before me. Your voice is not always my voice. Let not your name be vanity. Be still. Channeled by Gloria Wendroff. HeavenLetters.org